Hi, my name is Kylie, and welcome to Counting Money 2, Counting Coins. In this video, you will learn to count coins so that when you empty your piggy bank, you'll know how much money you have in all. Before watching this video, be sure you've understood the value of coins in the video titled Counting Money 1, The Value of Money, then come back to this one. You know that coins are small metal pieces of money. You also know that in the United States, we have coins that represent 1 cent or 1 penny, 5 cents or a nickel, 10 cents or a dime, and 25 cents or a quarter. When they're all mixed into a wallet, it might seem tricky to know how much money you have. But I'll show you how to count your coins. Let's go! Pennies equal 1 cent. But there are many pennies here. It's as easy to count pennies as it is to count objects because there is a 1-to-1 value. So, let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There are 12 pennies, so we say there are 12 cents. The correct way to represent money is through the decimal system. In video 1, we simply wrote 12 cents like this. But anytime we are counting, adding, subtracting, multiplying, or dividing money, we should write it as a decimal or in a dollar notation, like this. With the 1 in the tens place and the 2 in the hundreds place. And we drop the cent symbol and add a dollar sign at the front of the decimal number. This symbol tells us we're talking about money. We use the decimal system because cent is a dollar divided into 100 parts. Remember that cent is Latin for 100. Since there are no dollars or whole amounts, we place a 0 in the ones place, and the decimal point separates the dollars from the cents. If you want to learn more about decimals, be sure to watch our videos. Next, let's count nickels. Be careful! We can't count nickels as we'd count pennies because nickels are worth 5 cents each. This means we'll need to count by fives. Let's do it. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. We have 35 cents. But did you know that we can use a shortcut to count nickels? If you know how to multiply, we can count the number of nickels you have in all and multiply that by 5. Since nickels are worth 5 cents. Since we have 7 nickels, we can multiply that by 5 and we get 35 cents. We're right. Just like nickels, we need to count dimes differently from pennies because dimes are worth 10 cents each. This time, we'll count by tens. You got it. Let's count. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. We have 70 cents. Let's try the shortcut by multiplying the number of dimes, 7, by the amount of a dime, 10. This gives us 70 cents. Yes! When adding quarters, what do you think we'll need to count by? If you said by 25, you're correct. Let's count these quarters. 25, 50, 75, we have 75 cents. And using the shortcut, if we have 3/4 and multiply that by the value 25, 3 times 25 equals 75 cents. You can also count coins when they're all mixed up, like this. The easiest way to count coins is to place coins of the same value together first. So, quarters with quarters, dimes with dimes, nickels with nickels, and pennies with pennies. Next, begin counting with the coins of a greater value. In this case, it's quarters. We have 2/4 for a total of 50 cents. 4 dimes, so that's 40 cents. 2 nickels, making that 10 cents. And 3 pennies, or 3 cents. Let's add all that up. 50 plus 40 is 90, plus 10 cents is 100, but we know 100 cents is equal to $1. So that's $1 plus 3 cents is a total of $1.03. Now, we place the dollar sign in front of this amount and we're done. You now know how to count all those coins that you have in your piggy bank. What will you do with all those coins? Will you spend them or will you save them to buy something in the future? No matter what you do with your money, you can test your skills by counting money on our fun online games and quizzes. And remember to always be clever. Cha-ching! Hey, hey.